Deepfakes aren't on the way, they're here already. Artificial intelligence can now generate images of real people that are indistinguishable from photographs at first, second, and third glance. Videos are not far behind, and I can't wait until I finally look like Keanu Reeves. Several leading news providers, including the BBC, the CBC, and the New York Times, are now about to introduce content credentials to combat the spread of deepfakes. Let's have a look and see if it's the deepfake kryptonite that we've been waiting for. Deepfakes are fake images or videos produced with deep neural networks, which are currently the most powerful type of artificial intelligence. Deepfakes are usually created by swapping one face for someone else's, because creating a face from scratch is God's job. Deepfakes are a big problem because democratic governments rely on people to be well informed, and that's hard if your political leaders can be seen doing and saying anything. Though it'd be fun to see Biden dance with Trump, it'd also be kind of confusing, wouldn't it? This is why many countries and organizations have put money into finding solutions to the deepfake problem that AI has generated. One way you can fight against deepfakes is to try and develop software to tell it apart from the real thing. But this creates an arms race dynamic, or what biologists call co-evolution. The software that allows identifying deepfakes will ultimately just lead to better deepfakes, making them more and more sophisticated. Next thing you know, we're all being ruled by deepfake overlord Zucker Bezos, and it tells you a lot about the state of the world that this might not even be an entirely bad thing. The alternative is to better track the origin of images and video footage. The idea is now taking shape with what's been dubbed content credentials, a name so boring you just know it was created by committee. The introduction of content credentials is an initiative by the non-profit Coalition for Content Provenance and Authenticity. It's not one of those well-intended plans that never come into being. It's well on the way already. Many major companies that offer image editing software are integrating content credentials as we speak, including Adobe, Microsoft, and Leica. All right, but what are content credentials and how are they supposed to work? The idea is fairly simple. You know how any image can store data about what camera settings it was taken with and where it was taken? This is the metadata of the image, and you can find it if you click on properties of the image file. Content credentials basically add more information to that metadata. This info is encrypted, so it's not that easy to fake. The credentials include who made the image and when and how it's been edited. So if you fired up Photoshop's new AI Frankenstein tool, it'd get locked in the image credentials. The plan is that everyone should be able to check the content credentials on their browser. You just click on the CR icon on the image and it'll bring up the information. One click and you'll know if that viral image of a dog riding on a shark into a tornado was AI generated, or, you know, just a normal day in Florida. And that's great, but just exactly how will it prevent deepfakes? It won't. Putting credentials on images doesn't prevent anyone from producing deepfakes. If there's some software in which those credentials are updated automatically, this will make the faker's life a little bit harder. But all they have to do is take a snapshot of the final image and claim it as their own and original work. Now, the content credentials website offers a reverse image search where you should be able to search for meshes of one image with other images. And that'll work to some extent. But it has an obvious problem. Photos of one and the same person all kind of look alike, deepfaked or not. And in the end, the problem then comes back to how do you tell apart a deepfake from a genuinely new photo? But content credentials can work nevertheless. It's not because of the image tracking per se, it's to do with the trustworthiness of the image source. If you have an image with credentials from the BBC, maybe, just maybe, you trust it more than something uploaded by SpecsOpsAnarchist42 206, who has 7 followers on Twitter. Of course, at the moment, the websites where images are hosted also give us some information, but with the content credentials, it's more directly linked to the content, which I think is a good idea. However, this just brings up the question of who watches the watchman. Which sources are we to regard as trustworthy and why? And how are we supposed to check trustworthiness? With trustworthiness credentials? It'll be credentials all the way down. When we discuss the entire deepfake issue, I think we should keep in mind what scientists have found out about why fake news spread in the first place. It's not so much that people are too stupid to identify fake news if they think about it, it's that they don't think about it in the first place. And what good are credentials if no one checks them? None of this is to say that I think it's a bad idea. Every quantum of friction we can add to the deepfake epidemic is worth it. It's just that I think the impact on how we consume and share news will be limited until the day when we'll all be on Neuralink and can just run critical think install.exe. It won't be long now, I'm sure. If you want to learn more about how neural networks work, I recommend you check out the neural network course on brilliant.org, who've been sponsoring this video. The neural network course will give you a deeper understanding of how intelligent artificial intelligence really is, with some hands-on examples. And Brilliant has courses on many other topics in science and mathematics too. Whether you're interested in neural nets or quantum computing or linear algebra, they have you covered. I even have my own course there. That's an introduction to quantum mechanics. It'll bring you up to speed on all the basics: interference, superpositions, entanglement, and up to the uncertainty principle and Bell's theorem. Brilliant is really the best place to build up your background knowledge on all those science videos which you've been watching. If you use my link brilliant.org/Sabine, you'll get to try everything Brilliant has to offer for free for a full 30 days, and you'll get 20% off an annual premium subscription. Links in the description below, so go and check this out.
Deepfakes.
Deepfakes.
Deepfakes. Deep, 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 deepfakes.
Thanks for watching. See you tomorrow.